Hi, I'm Daniel Martins, a postdoctoral researcher at Vista Mucosa 5 Research Center, and I'm based at TSSG, a research group from the Waterfall Institute of Technology. Today, I will present this poster titled Bacterial Molecular Computer on a Chip for Biosensing. The fast and accurate detection of molecules is an important tool to maintain the quality and sustainability of the Irish dairy industry, as they can signal the occurrence of abnormalities in animals and soil. Because of that, novel biosensors will be required to provide an omnipresent method to monitor all the dairy production-related processes, which will avoid draining natural resources and improve the animal care. Inspired by this scenario, we proposed the design of a portable and flexible biosensing system using engineered bacteria to detect biochemical molecules of interest. We named this device as Bacterial Molecular Computer on a Chip. A visual representation of the proposed device can be seen in this slide. We engineered two bacterial populations to compute biomolecules as Boolean logic gates, one AND gate and one on-off switch. Here we apply the concepts of digital electronics, where digital bits, zeros and ones, are used to represent electrical signals. However, in this case, the bit zero means lower concentration of molecules and the bit one represents higher concentration of molecules. We designed the AND gate by engineering the bacterial population to receive IPTG nitrile and output acid ammonia. Here, our interest is to detect higher concentrations of acid, which can create harmful conditions to the plant growth, as an example. The second bacterial population was engineered to behave as on-off switch by receiving acetate and outputting a variation on the dissolved oxygen concentration. In this case, the bacterial population will consume the dissolved oxygen only if the acetate concentration is above a certain level. These operation thresholds are dependent on several factors such as population type and size. Please note that the bacterial populations are contained inside a microfluidic chamber to avoid biocontamination and are placed on top of conventional electrochemical sensing chips, which will detect their output signal. Therefore, their design become modular, as the same chip can be reused several times. You just need to replace the bacterial populations accordingly to the biocomputing and biosensing needs. We evaluated the performance of the proposed system in terms of logic computation reliability when considering different theoretical scenarios. Figure A shows the reliability of the logic computation for both gates with and without production delay and noise, when the electrochemical sensor uses a standard detection estimator and considering different input signals concentration, different IPTG, nitrile, and acetate concentrations. Figure B shows the results for a similar scenario, but considering a blind detection estimator instead. The signal estimation is a necessary step for this system, as the electrochemical sensing chip may not know a priori the molecular concentration of the signal produced by the bacterial population. The results show us for the AND gate case that the concentration of the input signals can affect the reliability of the logic computation, especially for the blind detection estimator. This means that the measurement procedure needs to be careful to ensure the highest performance of the system. It is interesting to note that the on-off switch reliability is quite similar for both detector thresholds. This shows that for this particular logic gate, both techniques can be applied without affecting the overall performance of the bacterial molecular computer on a chip. It is also interesting to note that the AND gate has a better reliability for the blind detection estimator, more than 70%, when using input signal concentration above 2 millimoles per liter. From this study, we conclude that it's feasible to design a device with a good accuracy using engineered bacterial populations to better monitor the use of natural resources, avoiding the overuse of pesticides and fertilizers. In the future, we want to increase the system reliability to more than 90% and expand this sensing repertoire to compute and detect other biochemical signals. I would like to thank the SFI funding and my collaborators to support this investigation. Please feel free to contact me on my email address shown in this slide. Thank you for your attention.